Just off Michigan's US 10 is Idlewild, a community of about 1,500 people scattered amidst many vacant resort cottages and abandoned tourist businesses. Black tourists used to swarm to this vacation spot to escape the rudeness and prejudice of other more restricted resort areas. The Flamingo and Paradise clubs in Idlewild boasted jazz greats Ella Fitzgerald, Louis Armstrong, and Dinah Washington. Now they're silent, drained of their vivaciousness by the easing of racial discomfort and the acceptance of the Negro to other more alluring vacation spots. Idlewild on the whole is extremely quiet now. Its small lakes and many trees establish the mood of the town. The businesses that remain open are never crowded like in the old days. The shop owners open and close at their own leisure. No one complains. They still look back to when the town was bustling with tourists, and they still look forward to when some of that tourist business will return. Many of the older, more rotted buildings are coming down in an attempt to make Idlewild more attractive, less like the ghost town it's strenuously trying to avoid becoming. It's not a ghost town, it's a small town. One where the guys hang out at the combination hardware carryout store to look at the girls. It's a small town existing where a big town used to be. It's not a ghost town, but the good times in Idlewild are now family times. Today it's a place where picnics and barbecues fit right in with the lakes and forests. The mood is happy, not hurried. Cordial, not crowded. The train that used to bring hundreds of tourists to Idlewild tossed a spark into the National Forest the day we were there. That spark showed that Idlewild definitely is not a ghost town, as volunteers came from all over to fight the fire. Idlewild needs a spark of a different sort now to become a resort town again. Right now it's just a small town, ridden by reminders of a different, more lively town in a different time. This is Michigan Close-Ups in Idlewild.